Tents here are neighbors. They live beside each other in a fictitious neighborhood set in Constantia, which is an incredibly wealthy, plush area in Cape Town in South Africa. They are successful women in their own right. They are octogenarians. They are either widowed or in the process of being widowed. And the story, in many ways, I like to say, is about their hateship and the tensions of that kind of interaction. The question is, what is a feminist book? You know, that would be the question. And I don't begin writing with those kinds of headings. Not because there's anything wrong with that, but because that's not necessarily what feeds my creative energy. So I'm a feminist myself, so I think possibly what I write is imbued with some of my politics, but it's not. I don't begin writing saying I'm going to write a feminist book. I begin writing saying there's a voice in my head of this woman, and she's very upset. She's angry. She's tired. She's lived essentially an unfulfilled life. And I pick away at that voice. You know, I investigate this person. Why? How come? What happened to her? And that's how I write. I'm really interested in character. I'm interested in what's behind the facade. And often, I guess I'm slightly more fascinated in fascinated by what's bad about us rather than what's good. There are many places in the book where spatial terminology, architectural themes, ideas about how we occupy space are evident. And that's there for many reasons. One of the reasons I like to think of is one of the things these two women engage each other on is the fact of the past of the country they live in, South Africa, and apartheid. And if you think about apartheid, a lot of what apartheid was spatial oppression. And so themes of space and architecture and facadism and power, I mean, what is an architect if not a kind of a space Nazi? I don't know, can I say that on film? But you know, I'm an architect myself, so I can make fun of them. But space as a place to exert force and power. So yes, you're right. So the facade of things and what's behind the facade, the idea of what we build and what we don't build, the idea of where we can be spatially and where we can't be. So much of apartheid in terms of how it oppressed black people was in you can go there and you can't go there. You can walk here, but you can't walk there. You can stand here, but you can't own it. You can place your shack here, but you can't own the land it sits on. You can visit this, but you have to leave eventually. So that interested me and becomes, it's kind of part of the soup of the story. Well, hateship is so much more interesting than friendship. I mean, obviously friendship is incredible, but I think friendship and hateship are possibly the same thing. But always, I think it's useful to use language. It's interesting to use language to uncover some of the secret stuff. So friendship alone to describe that relationship is insufficient, and somehow hateship describes it is a more satisfying description for me because it tells you that there's discomfort. It tells you that there's dis-ease, and it tells you that there are questions here. Everything isn't settled. There's complexity here and there's nuance. I definitely want to be Hortensia. You know, when I turn 80, I want to be Hortensia's version of that. And I say that because there's a part of who she is that I admire, the part of her that doesn't give a damn. you know, and I think I'm still quite locked up in social expectations and politeness, and I just relish the way in which she has done away with that for herself and freed herself of that. It means that she's a little nasty, you know, but that's the byproduct of that sort of decision, and a part of me respects that, and I feel and wishes I could do the same. With Marion, you know, I have a lot of compassion for Marion. She's deeply flawed, and I think we all are in different ways. And what I hope is when people read the book, if people read the book, that that's one of the things you can come away with, that not just come away thinking, oh, those are really difficult women, but come away thinking, in some ways, that's me. And I think the readers I've met, particularly white readers, that have come to me and quietly confessed to the ways in which Marion reflects who they are some of the readers I have the most respect for, because we're not always willing to own up to what is our shadow. We're always happy to own up to what is, you know, shiny about us, but not the other side. And Marion is a character that can allow us to see, okay, we're problematic. We're not okay.